Next question is from Assembly Member Berry. That's about net loss of council homes.
Well, thank you, Chair. Building more council housing is one of my top priorities as Mayor. In 2018, I released over £1 billion to councils through my landmark Building Council Homes for Londoners programme. Last year, councils started over 4,390 new homes in London, of which 3,300 were supported by City Hall, the highest number since 1983. I'm proud of the success of this programme and the hard work of boroughs. My new £4 billion affordable homes programme will provide even further critical investment for new council homes in London. However, the evidence shows London's housing sector needs significantly more grant, £4.9 billion per year for the next 10 years, to meet the capital's level of affordable housing need. I'm calling on the government to step up and provide this investment. With the number of new council homes growing year on year, there is now only a slight decline in the overall stock of council housing in London, last year by less than 0.1%, representing the smallest decline since 1991, when records began. I'm hopeful that my policies, combined with the ambition and hard work of boroughs, will see this small decline turn into an increase for the first time in 30 years. I'm doing everything I can to make this happen. My new London plan requires that any existing council home lost to demolition are replaced by new housing at existing or higher densities with at least the equivalent level of floor space. The introduction of my 2018 Good Practice Guide to Estate Regeneration ensures that where GLA funding is sought, future demolitions only happen with the support of affected residents. Over time, the combined impact of these policies should ensure demolitions do not lead to a further reduction in council housing stock in the capital. However, it's clear that we're swimming against the tide of national government policies that hamper the efforts of councils to build homes. The government's right to buy policy is a major impediment to the sustained growth of council homes in London. It's clear that one-for-one replacements are not being achieved in London or elsewhere as a result of unfair restrictions placed on the council's use of right to buy receipts to fund new homes. If, like us, the government is serious about providing the homes Londoners need, it must remove these unnecessary restrictions to ensure boroughs can build at a rate that matches their ambition.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. I think we both have the same goal in mind here, which is more council homes. That's what Londoners need. And it's good to see the increase in council house building since 2016. That is progress. But it doesn't mean London's turned a corner in terms of the net loss of council homes on the ground. That's my topic today. Now, to track what's happening on the ground, I put out a report last week that talks about the planning pipeline, but today I've compiled data from the stock returns from councils. These have the overall numbers plus information on new builds, acquisitions, demolitions, sell-offs and right to buys. Adding them up, we get the net change, and we're still seeing every year council homes being lost in London more than are being built or acquired. Now, one of the biggest components of the net loss is, as you'd expect, as you've mentioned, right to buy. Last year, up to 2020, nearly 1,500 homes were lost that way in London. So starting with something we can agree on, what can we do about this together? Can we push the government harder for not just more, less restrictions on what to do with the funding that we get from right to buy, but an emergency suspension of right to buy? That would turn the numbers around in one go.
Well, it wouldn't, because you're not increasing the supply of new homes. All you're doing is stopping people from fulfilling their aspiration to be a homeowner. And it's a far more effective way to be a homeowner than other forms are. So I think we need to do a number of things. Firstly, to make sure that, that it's meaningful in relation to like-for-like replacement. And that means giving councils more ability to use the receipts from the sale of council homes to build new homes. So that means increasing the supply. I mean, since 1979, when right to buy first began, up until recently, for every five homes sold, only one was built. And so I accept that we're shrinking the amount of social homes, council homes available. And that's why, since I've become mayor, we've started to increase the numbers of council homes being built. And you've seen the policies in relation to estate regeneration. But we really urgently need to increase the numbers of council homes. That's why I continue to lobby the government in relation to the monies they give us. We can use it for those sorts of homes which Londoners need, rather than other sorts of homes that Londoners don't necessarily need as much.
Okay, I'm surprised to hear you back right to buy quite so strongly there. But my second question is about the other major contributor to the losses that are in the data returns. And this is demolitions. They aren't stopping. Your new policies aren't yet coming into effect. Last year, on the ground, the stock returns show 1,700 demolitions last year versus only 946 new builds. So overall, we now have a net loss of council homes last year of 3,600. That's an increase on the previous year. So I've got to raise the alarm that when we get the 2020 Housing Association data through in May, their new builds won't outweigh the lost council homes. We might see an overall net loss in social housing. So my question to you is, what more can we do? What emergency measures can you take to get more social housing into new build projects now to make up for this loss?
Well, firstly, I'm not sure if I accept those figures, but I'm sure that's just a question of dates, not because your figures aren't accurate. The figures I have is the numbers of homes demolished are council homes demolished are far less than council homes started. But that's one of the reasons that we've got policies in place now, both the London Plan and in relation to funding. So the London Plan is quite clear. If councils, for good reasons when it comes to regeneration, may want to demolish a home, they must replace at least a home lost with a new home, but often more. And that's why I refer to density. And secondly, if it's a wish of anybody to receive funding from GLA when it comes to estate regeneration, there must be a affirmative ballot of those residents living on an estate before regeneration take place.
I'm really sorry, I'm running out of my time now. I need to leave some for my colleague. But I'll keep talking to you about this. And if I can send you the data, that would probably clarify things for you as well.
As ever, and I think we're on the same side of the argument here. It's a question of how we get to the ends. But I'm more than happy to work with the member who's very constructive on these issues.
Thank you.